Hi, I'm Dr. Rhonda Lawes, and I want to welcome you to our Beginner's Guide to Medical Coding and Billing. Now, in this series, we're going to look at all the essential aspects of medical coding and billing, and I'm going to help you make sense of all the abbreviations and the language. As we jump into this topic, you'll discover how you, as a healthcare provider, are going to need to depend on accurate coding and billing processes in order for you to get proper payment for the services that you provide. Now, I'm going to break down the roles of the medical coders and billers so that you can understand how crucial their expertise and contributions are to the smooth functioning of the healthcare industry and to your personal reimbursement. Additionally, I'm going to provide an overview of the healthcare reimbursement system. Now, this will help you understand the financial side of the medical world. So first off, I wanted to start you with the definition of this rule book that the entire world uses for medical coding and billing. It's called the ICD-10. All right, that's the first one of our abbreviations I want to make sure you're really clear on. So the ICD-10 stands for International Classification of Diseases. The number 10 is the 10th revision. Now, 11 came out globally in January 1st, 2022, but the US isn't using that version yet when we're filming this video series. But watch for it, it's gonna roll out over the next 4 to 5 years in the US. So for now, all of our references will be to the ICD-10. So think of the ICD-10 as like this super organized system for classifying and sorting information about people's health, why they might get sick or even pass away. Now imagine if people from different countries wanted to share information about the health of their populations. Well, the ICD-10 helps them do that by providing a common language. So this is like super cool. It's like what we did with the INR, right? The internal normalized ratio, where we could compare lab values between different labs, different hospitals, they're all using the same references. That's all that ICD-10 is. It's taking the different language and things that we use in different places and bringing it all together with very clear definitions. So there's no way around it. You're going to have a lot of work to do to get familiar with what the criteria are. So I can't say it enough. You really need to become best friends with the medical billers and coders because they are the experts in the entire system. So this ICD-10 is like having a universal code or a set of rules so that everyone can understand and talk about health issues in the same way. Now this helps doctors, scientists, and health officials all around the world work together because they can compare data and they can find ways to improve everyone's well-being. Now in simpler terms, ICD-10 is like a global rule book, and this is what helps everyone understand and talk about the health problems from the same perspective. It just makes it easier for people from different places to share information and work together to make everyone healthy. Now, the ICD-10 was first published by the World Health Organization. You see that often abbreviated as WHO. It was done in 1992. Now, this version that we're talking about today, which is what ICD-10-CM is based on, was adopted by the United States in 1999 for cause of death. Okay, so let's go back and talk a little bit about that ICD-11, because you're probably wondering, what's the difference between ICD-11 and ICD-10, the one we are currently using in the US? Well, the biggest thing is this is the first version that is fully electronic, which gives you some pretty cool ways to search using this electronic search feature. Now, this version has access to 17,000 diagnostic categories. It has over 100,000 medical diagnostic index terms. And this index-based search algorithm interprets more than 1.6 million terms. So this is pretty cool. When ICD-11 rolls out and the US adopts it over a number of years, you're going to have some powerful search, which should save you significant time when you're seeking out the correct codes. You may also be wondering, what's the difference between the ICD-10 and the ICD-10-CM? Well, CM stands for Clinical Modification, and a division of the Department of Health and Human Services in the US was responsible for developing the program as an adaptation of the ICD-10. Now, they got authorization from the World Health Organization, but when these standards are used, you'll see CM, Clinical modification because it represents an adaptation of the ICD-10 that was authorized by the World Health Organization. So let's pause for just a minute and kind of think back and reflect on what we've just talked about in this beginning discussion, the value of the ICD. So in medical coding and billing, there's significant value in having this consistent language, or the ICD. So because this was created and adopted, we have this standardized language that is used globally that does three things. It improves communication, helps compare outcomes, and it increases the efficiency of reimbursement.